Good morning, friends. The Elizabethan poetry is very vast, and the development of sonnets in the early 16th century is one stage of development in poetry in the Renaissance period. Apart from those early poets like Thomas Watt and Surrey, we have the next great world of poets in the form of Edmund Spenser and Sir Philip Sidney. Edmund Spenser is supposed to be the greatest of Renaissance poets because of his revolutionary writing. Along with Edmund Spenser, we have equally significant poet called Sir Philip Sidney. Sir Philip Sidney is, in a way, a representative of the true Renaissance spirit of England, that is, the ideal representative of a perfect gentlemanliness in Elizabethan English poetry. The character of Philip Sidney is identified as such a perfect name for ideal gentlemanliness. The nature and imagery are two significant aspects of Philip Sidney's poetry. Sir Philip Sidney went to nature for the source and the background in his poetry. He took nature as a tremendous source of developing images, ideas, and imagery in his poetry. So, nature and imagery are two inseparable aspects of Philip Sidney's poetry. Sir Philip Sidney is highly imaginative in his poems. His major poem is Arcadia. Arcadia is a highly imaginative poem that deals with love songs. A vast collection of poems which deal with the theme of love and emotion. Philip Sidney is a poet who depended more on lyricism, emotion, imagination in his poetry. He is a highly imaginative writer who made the next generation of poets look back to his poetry. Arcadia is one such significant poem of Sir Philip Sidney. And another significant poem is Astrophel and Stella. Astrophel and Stella is, like the previous one, very much lyrical in nature. It is one of the fine examples of lyrical love poetry. The poetry is a sonnet sequence throughout its work, and the way in which Philip Sidney combined all aspects of lyricism, sonnet sequence, and theme of love, and the images or imagery and highly imaginative quality is all inseparable blend of his true spirit of idealism. Astrophel and Stella is basically Sidney's poem that is his love for Penelope. Penelope was an English beauty who was a sister of Earl of Essex. Philip Sidney's unforgettable love for Penelope, his beloved, is produced in the form of this sonnet sequence. It is lyrical and lovely and affectionate and full of emotion and imagination because of this background of his love theme and the revelation of his love for a beauty called Penelope. Though Philip Sidney could not express in complete sense his love, it is a series of those love sonnet sequences that make that work remarkable. Though in terms of output, the works of Philip Sidney are very less. They are very significant in terms of their impact. Philip Sidney's emotion and his imagination are the two great experiments that any poet can borrow from Philip Sidney, because Edmund Spenser and Philip Sidney, apart from Shakespeare as a sonneteer, are two great poets of Elizabethan period who made a real revolution in terms of their contribution. And for the next century, 17th century, the poets could turn back to these two poets. That is where the greatness of Sir Philip Sidney lies. He was a courtier and affectionate and a gentleman who could use all these aspects of his personal life and stature in producing a great poem in the form of Arcadia and Astrophel and Stella. These two poems, though less in terms of number, are remarkable contributions of Philip Sidney to the 16th century poetry, or to the Renaissance period in England. The medieval period, or Greco-Roman culture, literature and learning that came to England through translation, through philosophers, etc., were a source of information, a source of background for these poets to develop their career and establish their name as great poets. Sidney and Spenser, in that sense, are true great poets of Elizabethan period. Thank you.